We've got the brand new Google Pixel Book in front of me today. And now it's got its own companion pen as well, the Pixel Book pen. It also works with Google Assistant. If you guys watch the keynote, you can circle somebody's face. It looks up that person, it searches them and so on. And then you can also activate Assistant with your voice. If you look right over here, 7th generation Intel Core i5 processor, 8 gigs of RAM, a 256 gigabyte SSD. So if what you are looking for is a machine that can do what your smartphone does, but potentially faster and with the input method of a keyboard and with a bigger display, this could be your companion. Is it going to be a replacement for your laptop, though? That kind of depends on what you do on your laptop. If you're like me and you do a lot of video editing, well, probably not. But if you're a person who's mostly inside of email and web browsers and so on, it might do a better job than what you're using right now. Ooh. Nice little experience there. So what you're gonna see here is that the design cues are taken from the Pixel phones with this strip along the top. This is quite thin and light. I think it's around 2.5 pounds. Metallic construction. On this side over here is a Type-C USB connector. And if I flip it around to the other side, there's another Type-C connector as well as a headphone jack. Also here is what looks like volume and then probably a power switch. Ooh, solid, surprisingly solid. Look, it's booting up straight away. Okay, now one thing I like about these is the aspect ratio of the screen. Now, everything on the desktop and in smartphones is going taller, but there is a case to be made for a more traditional aspect ratio when it comes to productivity. Things like email and so on work really well on a screen like this. The keyboard here is backlit. It's a chiclet style, kind of MacBook-esque. The trackpad is glass. It actually feels quite nice. And then where your palms rest is crazy soft. Wow. This could be a nice place to type. Now, of course, the magic happens when we flip this over like this. Look at that. All of a sudden now, you're in tent mode. And then, of course, we can fold it completely flat because it is a touchscreen interface. It's capable of running Chrome apps, web apps, or Android apps. So it essentially turns into an Android tablet when you're holding it like this. Also inside the box, we have some slender paperwork there, a USB power brick, Type-C connector there, and of course, a relatively long USB Type-C cable. Now, of course, we've also got the pen, so I wanna crack this open. It's a quadruple A. Oh my goodness. I feel like I need to reevaluate my existence, my childhood. And of course, since it's using the Wacom technology in here, you have a pen tip similar to what you would have on a Wacom drawing tablet. You might be thinking, why wouldn't it just be rechargeable? Well, the battery lasts a really long time. I don't know if you've seen pictures of the Apple Pencil charging, but it's a little awkward to say the least. Now would be a good time to mention that Google claims you can get 10 hours of battery life out of this. Of course, that's gonna vary depending on your usage. So I've got it booted up now. You have your web apps, your basic ones down below. You know, you've got Chrome where most things are gonna happen, Gmail, Docs, and of course YouTube. Now it's chewing through this 4K video streaming like nobody's business. All right, so if you're wondering the benefit of having more horsepower on a Chromebook, this is the kind of thing that can bog down some laptops just even doing a 4K stream. So you're looking at 2400 by 1600 pixels. It's a lot taller than you might be used to if you're using a traditional laptop right now, a widescreen version. But at a 12.3-inch form factor, that's quite a lot of pixels to play with, hence the image quality. Look at that. I mean, it is so responsive. Inside of Chrome, it's about as fast as I've ever experienced. Even when I go just to like load up a new video, it's like, now obviously that takes into account my internet speed here, but I've used many laptops on this particular internet. So now what's special here is there's a few different ways to launch into Assistant. I can do so with the dedicated Assistant button, I can do so with my voice, or I can do so with the pen and the button that's featured on the pen. So for starters, I'm gonna try the key. From here, I can type in a request, a question or something like that, or I can hit the microphone button here and use my voice as input. So that's probably the coolest way, to be honest. Okay, Google. Who is Willie Do?
Here is a matching video.
Definitely not Willie Do. You need to step your internet profile game up, all right, sir? Okay, Google, what is Unbox Therapy?
According to LinkedIn, Lewis Hilsendinger is the creator of Unbox Therapy, an online show dedicated to consumer products.
Okay, Google, how much does the Pixel Book cost?
According to The Verge, Google's Pixelbook laptop starts at $999 and can be priced all the way up to $1,649.
It doesn't end there, because I can use the pen for Assistant as well. So if I launch into the web browser here and look at images, check this out. I can hold this button, circle my face, and it'll figure out who I am. Lewis Hilsenseger, internet personality. Here's Mount Everest. Now let's circle it. Oh, Mount Everest. They nailed it. Even though it's just a mountain. Okay, Google. Play Unbox Therapy videos. Oh, wow. Okay. Now let's listen to a little bit of SoundCloud real quick to check out these speakers. It's firing up there. I mean, they're decent. They're not the best laptop speakers I've ever heard. I really don't recommend using speakers in general on a laptop if you don't have to. I mean, if you can put headphones on, it's gonna be a lot better. This does have a dedicated headphone jack that you can utilize, but they get the job done if you quickly need to watch a video and so on. That's kind of cool. This button on the side, the power switch, if you just tap this button here, it kind of starts to fade away, and then if you hold it long enough, it'll log you out. It's kind of like a quick dedicated logout button. Smart lock for Chromebook beta. Unlock your Chromebook with your Android phone. I'm gonna try to set this up right now. Your phone is locked. Unlock it to enter. Are you seeing this right now? Okay, here we go. I'm gonna do this. This could be magic. Fingerprint. And click your photo. I'm in. So I'll sleep it again. And now it looks, and it goes yellow. It stays locked. Your phone is locked. Unlock it to enter. So I pick up the phone, use my fingerprint. You saw the green immediately go to the unlock position. Okay, so there you have it. The brand new Pixelbook unboxed. Test it out a little bit. Obviously, I need to use this more comprehensively before I make up my mind about how much I like it and so on, and if it can replace my other equipment. To be honest, I think at home, this could be convenient. I have a laptop and I kind of use it on the couch and I put it on the coffee table, and all I really do is watch video, deal with email here and there. I'm not editing video on that machine. It's strictly for basic productivity, a document here and there. And that's where I could see something like this possibly being a step better. When you add in the pen, Google Assistant aspect, and most importantly, the fact that this thing is convertible, it becomes somewhat compelling. Now, I know what you're gonna say. You're gonna say, but Lou, you could do that with Surface products. And you're right, you can. And Surface products are really good. I'm not taking anything away from them. But there is a customer out there who doesn't need a full-fledged OS. At $1,000, I think a lot of people will still choose a Surface product. But I am happy that this thing exists for what it is. I'm gonna try to use my voice more frequently with it and see if we're ready for the Google Assistant future. Not just in our phones and our home devices, but maybe in our laptops. We'll see.